you're here for a story. How about the story of my son, who isn't actually my son? Jack Ellis Ludwig Elfelton. Jack has always been a little different. Unique, even. You see, Jack was the exact opposite of a late bloomer. By age 4, he was already twice the size of his peers. And he just kept growing. Doing normal elf things was hard for him. Aw, look at this one. He had difficulties with Mr. Fa-la-la-la-la-su.
Snowy Sheep, why am I different from all the other elves?
It's because you're not an elf, Jack. You're human.
Well, if I'm not an elf, where am I from? Where's my family?
Jack, you see this here map? You see this island here? That's called Long Island. That's where you're from. That's where your father is.
Well, how can I find him?
Jack, go to the broadcast studio. Find someone there. They'll help you.
It's a broadcast studio.
It's the most wonderful and magical place with cameras, teleprompters, and George Hogan.
Who's George Hogan? Is he my dad?
No, that's just George Hogan.
Oh.
Anyways, go, Jack. Go. Go find your dad and spread the Christmas cheer.
Thanks, Snowy. Welcome to Manhasset Media Minute, Winter Wonderland Edition. I'm your host, Jack Elfelton.
And I'm George Hogan.
And today we're covering the live-action Christmas classic, Elf. Directed by Jon Favreau, Elf was released on November 7th, 2003. The story revolves around Buddy, a boy raised as an elf in the North Pole. Upon discovering that he's actually a human, Buddy travels to New York City to find his biological father, getting into trouble and spreading Christmas cheer along the way.
Okay, people, tomorrow morning, 10 a.m., Santa's coming to town.
Santa! Oh my God! He's a fake!
Starring Will Ferrell, Buddy the Elf serves as a foil to his father, the stubborn and cold Walter Hobbs, played by James Caan.
Your father, he's on the naughty list.
No!
The contrast between Buddy and his father, as well as the fairly normal city residents, plays into the comedy of the movie and highlights Buddy's strange elf mannerisms in a comedic light.
Elf earned about $31 million on its opening weekend and reached number one in the box office on its second weekend, earning an additional $26 million. Elf grossed over $173 million in the United States, a strong but not exceptional figure. However, Elf received positive reviews from fans and critics alike. Reviewers highlighted the family-friendly Christmas fun that was seemingly mixed with Will Ferrell's comedic performance. Elf has maintained its longevity every Christmas since its release and is widely regarded as a Christmas classic. Additionally, it consistently ranks in the top 10 on the list of most entertaining blogs and magazines. So, Jack, how do you feel about Elf?
In my humble opinion, Elf is the quintessential Christmas movie. With Buddy the Elf's outwardly charm, the movie's wonderful use of physical humor, clever wordplay, and sentimental themes, Elf is without a doubt stood through the test of time. It wonderfully encapsulates what a Christmas movie should be and is an enjoyable watch for all audiences. How about you, George?
I'd have to agree with you. The movie perfectly balances holiday cheer with its comedy, all while managing to be interesting and appropriate to all audiences. The beautiful yet realistic New York Christmas sets, combined with John Debney's amazing score, really sell the Christmas atmosphere and make the movie a blast to watch.
We here at Manhasset Media Minute give Elf the elusive 5 out of 5 Snowy Shees. Elf is a phenomenal comedy and absolutely essential every Christmas season.
That's all we have for today. I'm George Hogan.
And I'm your host, Jack Elfelton. Now, I'm off to find my dad. Excuse me, I gotta find my dad!
Okay, cool, go to bed!
Are you my dad?
No.
Oh, okay, bye. Are you my dad?
No.
Okay! Are you my dad?
No.
Oh.
George, I don't think I'm gonna find my dad, man.
Don't worry, he's out there somewhere. You'll find him.
Thanks.
I'm probably not gonna find my dad, but safe to say, I'm comfortable in the broadcast studio. It's not lavish, but I call it home.
Ho, ho, ho!